My dear student, very good morning all of you. Myself Anjum Upadhyay, working as assistant professor in Galgotia's University. So today I am going to take your class from MSN 2, Medical Surgery 2. Subject code is 3001 and topic is cardiopulmonary resuscitation, which is the lecture 2. Student, this is a continuation of last lecture. In this lecture, we will be learning method of CPR. Okay, as we know, CPR is associated with chest compression along with rescue breathe. Okay, so we will be learning method of chest compression first. So this is the rhythmic application of pressure over the lower half of the sternum. First, one rescuer, the one who is going to give chest compression, need to sit on the knees. So he will be leaning as close to the side of the victim's chest as possible and place the heel of one hand in the center of victim's chest between the nipples and place the other hand on the top of first one and interlock the finger like this. So heel of the should be placed on the patient's chest and it should be interlocked with the pressure of other hand, and the rescuer should be kneel position, means he should be straight. See, his upper body should be straight so that upper body pressure should go on the patient palm only, as we have seen in the last lecture. Students, this method is little bit different in terms of in case of children and in case of infants. So while we are giving CPR to children, we will be placing our one hand, only single hand, providing the cardiac or chest compression. Whereas if you are doing this same procedure with any infants, then we will be using our two finger. Okay, so compression rate should be 100 compression per minute with compression depth of 1.5 to 2 inches, which is approximately 4 to 5 centimeter. It allowing the chest return to its normal position completely after each compression with equal compression and